हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, कैसे हैं आप सभी। आज हम आए हैं आपके लिए लेकर दिस पोयम अ फोटोग्राफ। दिस इज फॉर क्लास 11th। दिस हैज बीन कंपोज बाय सरली टॉल्सन एंड इन दिस पोयम फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू दैट एज फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर बुक यू हैव रेड द पोर्ट्रेट ऑफ ए लेडी बाय खुशवंत सिंह। I can say that this poem is having a thematic similarity with that first story. Yes, thematic similarity means there was also the sense of photograph and portrait, and here also in this poem it has been described about photograph. So, without making any late, I am coming to the poem, and paragraph wise I am going to tell about the poem. Before this, little I would like to tell about the poem. This poem, a photograph, actually the poetess is looking at the photograph which has been pasted in the cardboard, and that photograph is having the photo of her mother. While she is writing this poem, composing this poem, her mother is no more, and in that photo her mother is of 12 years, and she has gone to the sea beach with her uncle and with her two cousins. So how the time is changed and how everything is totally changed with the passage of time, and what effects it has made on them, that will read here in this poem. So coming to the poem, the cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling, each one holding one of my mother's hands, and see, the big girl, some 12 years or so, all three stood still to smile through their hair. Poet is telling, making the picture of that, that what is seen over there in that photo. That photo has been taken at the seashore when her mother along with her two cousins and her uncle had gone to sea beach on a Sunday holiday. And as you know that if we go on some picnic, we have camera with ourselves, with us, then they have taken. And both the girls, all three girls are just paddling. They are jumping into the water in sea. And that time this photo has been snapped by the uncle of the poet's mother. That the same she is telling, that poet's mother is that time of 12 and her cousins were younger than her. And they all are paddling, and she is in the middle, her mother is in the middle, and they all are paddling in the water. She was the biggest, tallest and eldest of them, and uncle is taking photograph. They were all smiling because their hairs were scattered on their face, and they are smiling because their photo is going to be taken. At the uncle with the camera, a sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born. And the sea, which appears to have changed less, was their terribly transient feet. Yes, Bert is telling that they are looking at the camera, their uncle is taking the photograph, and that time her mother's face was very sweet. She is recalling through the photo, although she was not born that time. And she is saying, now she is becoming serious, she is saying that sea which appears to have changed less. There is no change in the sea. Sea is nearly the same, but lots of changes are there in these girls. Means her mother and mother's cousins. And that is sea water is terribly transient feet washing. Sea water is washing their feet, which is terribly transient. Transient means temporary, not permanent. That feet is not always the same. Lots of changes. They had grown up now. They are grown up now. Some 20-30 years later, sea would laugh at the snapshot. See Betty and Dolly, she would say, and look how they dressed us for the beach. She is saying that after 20-30 years of that photograph, her mother laughs at the photo when she looks at it. And she is telling that, see Betty and Dolly. Betty and Dolly, these two cousins of her mother. And her mother would say that, see how they are dressed for the picnic, for the sea beach when they have gone. And sea holiday was her past, mine is her laughter, both lie with liberties of loss. She is telling that if her mother would be looking at the picture with her, then both will be sad with the labored ease of loss. This is oxymoron, irony. Labored ease of loss. Ease, asani se, labored with difficulty. Means how time passes, no one knows. And why both will be sad? Because that time, if her mother would be living there, then her mother would be thinking about that past, which is no more with her. That's why she would be sad. And because her mother is no more, poet's mother is no more, so poet is sad. She is not here, so that poet could see her face. Mine is her laughter, yes. But for her, it was laughter also. If she would be telling with her mother that how you are dressed in your childhood, you see your picture, it was a matter of law for the poet. Both rye with labored ease of loss. Now she has been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived, and of this circumstance there's nothing to say at all. It's silence silences. And poet is saying that now her mother is no more. She is dead nearly 12 years ago when she is writing. And when she looks at that photograph, she goes in that past when her mother was alive. Now she is no more. So in this circumstance, she said nothing. She becomes silence. Because she becomes sad. So you will see in this poem that what does photograph gives? You will also be having lots of old photograph. Photograph gives you memory. And while you think about that memory, sometimes you become very happy to memorize that moment, and sometimes you become very sad also, because the participants in that photograph are not available there with you with that time in comparison to that pleasant period. Now it becomes sad for you. So students, I hope that you will have understood this poem. And now I am coming with some of its questions. What is the significance of sea holiday here? Yes, what is the significance of sea holiday here? It has become a historical thing for them. They have gone and they have taken that picture. That is a kind of pleasure for them. Second, sea holiday was her past, mine is her laughter. Explain, yes. Poet is telling that see, if her mother would be alive, then sea holiday was her past. She would see this picture and she would memorize her past. And mine is her laughter. Poet is telling that for myself, it is a thing of laughter. Yeh hansi ka vishay mere liye tha. Main apni maa ke bachpan ko photo ko dekhti aur uske saath dekhti. Clear? Third, what is labored ease of loss? Yes. Friends, how time passes, no one knows. And nothing is permanent in the world. In this universe, nothing is permanent. Everything is temporary. How satiric it is that in temporary life, we search everything permanent. The same thing poet says here, what's labored ease of loss? Labored ease of loss, loss means difficulty with the time. But how it comes, how easily it comes, no one knows. No one can see the time. It can be only realized. Students, hope you will like the video. Go through it. You will understand the poem. If you have any type of query, you can leave me a message. You can type your question over here. Certainly, I'll try my best to solve all your problems. Hope the best. And again, I'm requesting, appealing to you all that please don't forget to subscribe my channel so that, and also push the button of bell icon so that next of my video could easily reach to you. Thank you. Stay blessed. Jai Hind.